I'll keep it here.
Mrs. Shilpa Shetty Kundra on cloud 9. May I invite our chief guest to please, chief guest Mrs. Shilpa Shetty to please come and address us. Thank you.
Members of the dais, Dr. Kishore, Mr. Ramachandra, Surendraji, ladies and gentlemen, members of the press, a very, very good afternoon to everyone. It's an absolute pleasure to be here. This is the second Cloud 9 hospital that I'm inaugurating, the first one being in Chandigarh. The reason I feel happy to be here and to be part of such an auspicious event is, as a woman, I really believe and feel that it is every woman's inalienable right to have the best health care, especially when she's about to deliver or when she conceives. It's very important that she's given the right information, she's educated, she's made to feel important. And I think that happens when you have healthcare specialists who are able to make her understand that it is not just the child that is important, but also the mother. So I really love the fact that at Cloud 9, they're emphasizing on those important aspects, and a huge congratulations to the great work that you're doing. It's a one-stop shop, and it makes me very happy that, you know, they have everything from intensive care, pediatric services, neonatology, fertility. I just think it's a very important aspect, and like Doc said, you're never too old to get pregnant or have a baby. It's very encouraging. Maybe I'll come to you. I haven't reached the madness stage yet, but I think another child would be nice. But hearty congratulations, and I really hope that today's day you're going to deliver not just babies but also dreams that come true for a lot of women, because I really think in this time and age it's quite scary to reveal the numbers, but it is an honest truth that there are literally 40,000 maternal mortality numbers that are rising in India. So it's literally like an airplane crashing every day. And I really believe that pregnancy and delivery should be a celebratory experience, should be a memorable experience and not a fearful experience, which I'm sure women, all the men are like, they have this confused expression, but all the women are nodding, because only we know how daunting it is when you have the responsibility and onus of making another human being inside you. And I really think it's also a miracle. So having something like Cloud 9 reassuring you and making sure that from the time that you conceive to the time that you have your baby in your arms, it's going to be a memorable and a celebratory experience, I can only welcome it. So hearty congratulations, and I'm not going to take any more of your time. Thank you so much for inviting me. Ek mahila hu aur main janti hu ki maa banne ka jo ek responsibility hota hai, jab bachcha aap conceive karte hain, tab se lekar delivery tak bahut sare vichar aate hain, you know, हमारे मन में. और एक अच्छे हेल्थ केयर प्रोफेशनल का होना बहुत ज़रूरी है, एक डायरेक्शन का होना बहुत ज़रूरी है, ये रीअश्योरेंस होना कि आप अच्छे हाथ में हैं इज़ वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो आई थिंक दे हैव दैट. और जैसे इनको मेरी सराहना की ज़रूरत ही नहीं है, यही काफ़ी है बोलना कि अब तक जितनी भी डिलीवरीज की हैं उन्होंने, दे इज़ नॉट बिन अ सिंगल यू नो मोर्टैलिटी रेट. So I really think that is a huge compliment for the hospital.
Thank you. Mera question Dr. Kishore sir se. So Delhi mein abhi yo Max hospital mein kuch issue hua tha, premature baby ka dead declare kiya tha.
What is the reason for that, sir? Is the negligence of the doctor or any other issues are there?
Look, I'm glad you raised that question. I think the media has to report this properly. Let me explain. Indian law says that any baby born less than 28 weeks is not viable, according to Indian law. And any baby born less than 20 weeks is called abortion. Now, that leaves the baby is born between 20 and 28 weeks in a limbo. Now, throughout the world, babies born above 24 weeks are resuscitated, saved, because there is technology available, extreme good care is available, but there is a cost of treatment for extremely premature. It is not going to be cheaper. So 24 to 28 weeks, according to international standards, we resuscitate and save. Now, throughout the world, 22 weeks, nobody tries to save, because even if the baby survives, the morbidity, that means the disability, is almost guaranteed to be 100% at 22 weeks. Now, these twins which born in Max Hospital are twins born at 22 weeks. So technically, doesn't matter which country they go to, in the current knowledge and expertise, they are not savable. The only problem is, I think there was a misconception that the baby had died. And sometimes, if the baby has a heart rate of 10 or 15, it may not be picked up with the proper auscultation or listening by the stethoscope. So they might have done a mistake. It's not an intentional mistake. And these things sometimes, you know, reported in a different way. So that's why there's an investigation going on, and the investigation hasn't concluded anything. But the media has already done the damage, you know. The doctor is guilty, hospital is guilty. So this is the latest trend, crucifixion by media. So I think when today I was reading a newspaper, they were talking about prostate cancer in women. So when you report something, you need to get the facts correctly. And I congratulate media in doing a lot of things correctly, but sometimes you do get it wrong. So this particular event, I think, needs to be written properly. 22 weeks, according to world standards, nowhere in the world anybody resuscitates a baby at 22 weeks.
Sir, pahli delivery ke liye adarsh umar kya hai? What is the ideal age for first delivery?
Ideal age for the first delivery is beyond 20. You are legally allowed to marry after the age of 18, and definitely you are allowed to have a child after the age of 21. But that is the reason a lot of people have problems, because if you have a baby too young, then your chances of having dying in the labor, complications are higher. If you have a baby too late, that is, you know, from a woman's perspective, if you have a baby after the age of 30 years, they are considered as elderly primy. Elderly primy means there is a first child happening after the age of 30. They are at risk of a lot of chromosomal problems like Down syndrome. So they need to have to undergo a lot of tests. So the ideal age to have a first child is between 21 and 30.
The ideal age is also when you have an ideal husband. Try that.
मेरा एक सवाल है शिल्पा जी से जो पद्मावती के ऊपर अभी फिल्म को लेकर चल रहा है
ये माइक ना फेंक के मारूंगा
तो उसके ऊपर अभी
आपका इलाज हो जाएगा इधर
तो आप क्या उस पर प्रतिक्रिया कुछ देना
मैं दीपिका पादुकोण हूँ
नहीं नहीं फिर भी
मैं संजय लीला भंसाली लग रही हूँ आपको हाँ तो मैं तो कह रही हूँ ये तो मेरे इंडस्ट्री के फ्रेटर्निटी के लोग हैं पिक्चरें बनती हैं बहुत मेहनत के साथ
अपना काम करो ना अपना काम कर रहे
हैं नो वी विल आंसर योर क्वेश्चन वी आर प्लानिंग
हाँ किशोर जी इसका जवाब देंगे
We are planning to invite Padmavati to Cloud 9. Don't worry.
क्या बात है?
मैं उनसे बात करने इसलिए बात कर रहा
हूँ. हाँ पूछे ना. मैंने बोल मैंने जवाब दे दिया आपको.
So last question please.
आप सभी से पूछना चाहता हूँ. कि गरीब तबके के मरीज का कोई विशेष सुविधा इस अस्पताल में आपने किया है इतनी ही जानकारी चाहिए
सॉरी कैन यू रिपीट द क्वेश्चन
जो गरीब तबके के मरीज हैं उनके विशेष में आपके यहाँ क्या सुविधा है
look, we don't want to pronounce saying that we will look after the poor, because once you say that, it will be floodgates open. Yes. Recently, I don't know how many of you read Deccan Herald in Bangalore. We had a child, female child, who was abandoned by somebody into the bush. So somebody went to take a leak and they found this baby found alive.
Hello, hello.
And they brought the baby to Cloud 9 and through the police. So it was a medical legal case. So we said we will resuscitate this baby and save the baby, but we will not be able to continue because it's a medical legal case. Please take to the government hospital. The police officers in Bangalore, I am very proud of them. They put the money on the table and said, doesn't matter how much it costs, we want the baby to be treated in Cloud 9. We are not going to take this baby anywhere. So we decided we will save this baby and doesn't matter what the cost of the treatment. Now, the temperature of the baby when they brought to us was 30 degrees Celsius. Normal temperature being 36 degrees Celsius. So that means the baby was almost frozen. When it's frozen, in a common man's language, what happens is the pressure, blood pressure in the lungs go very high. That is what we call the pulmonary hypertension. And the blood pressure in the rest of the body, which everybody knows, will go very low. So you have to treat this baby balancing the blood pressure in the body and reducing the blood pressure in the lungs. And the baby was very, very critical. And we kept the baby on artificial breathing with various medications for 7 days. Actual cost of treatment for such a baby in Cloud 9 would have been 4 lakhs. We treated with very minimal cost and the baby was sent home and all the nurses fell in love with the baby and they named the baby Anamika and they wanted to adopt the baby because Cloud 9 saved this baby. And we didn't go to media with the story. The orphanage published the story in Deccan Herald. You can actually look it up and we have done it, but we don't boast such things because that's not the right thing to do. But as I said, if any poor patient comes, we have never refused treatment. Doesn't mean that we will do only charity, then we will not be able to survive.
Hello.
Finally, this is the last question, please. Finally, last question.
Yeah. Hi, my question again is for Dr. Kishore. This is not my individual perception, but a very generic one. The fancy hospitals, the high-end hospitals, they are usually considered pushing in for cesarean sections over the normal delivery. So what is Cloud9's take on that?
Fantastic. That's a very good question you asked.
Because I'm a doctor myself, so I understand, but I want you to explain this to everyone else.
Okay. So very good question. Our question is why cesarean sections are increasing. Now tell me how many of you drink Coke and eat sweets. Please raise your hands. Virtually everybody. You know, the lifestyle is changing. 30% of pregnant women, we have done a survey in Cloud 9, have a condition called gestational diabetes. Now, gestational diabetes is diabetes present during pregnancy. What happens when you develop diabetes during pregnancy? Your babies are going to be bigger. And people are growing bigger babies. Second thing is, in the past 10 years ago, 15 years ago, even today, if you go to a government hospital, the number of women who undergo IVF treatment or artificial insemination and treatment is virtually zero. People who come to private hospital or corporate hospitals, they don't have enough time to have sex, so they depend on IVF. Now, when you have IVF treatment, what happens is, naturally, the chances of having your C-section is higher. When you have gestational diabetes, your chance of having C-section is higher. Rich people have a high chance of developing blood pressure. They develop what is called as a pregnancy-induced hypertension. If you develop pregnancy-induced hypertension, your chances of developing C-section is higher. I don't know how many of you have been to Bangalore. If you go to old government hospitals in Bangalore, even today, there is a ward called eclampsia ward. That means, if any pregnant woman develops a convulsion, they used to throw them on the eclampsia ward because they believed that ghost possessed them. And now medically, we know that eclampsia happens if your blood pressure shoots up. So you deliver them quickly so that you control. So there are multiple reasons why the cesarean sections happen more commonly nowadays compared to in the past. And comparing government hospital to private hospital is like comparing oranges to apples. And that doesn't make any sense. Nobody does any C-section unnecessarily unless there is an indication. And we are one of the very few hospitals, especially Our national director is here, Dr. Arvind Kasaragod. We have been monitoring number of C-sections, number of normal deliveries. Every C-section, we question the doctor. So no other hospital questions the doctors about why you did a C-section. We have been monitoring that, and we definitely don't do C-sections unnecessarily.
Thank you.
मैम ये इस पे बोल दीजिए
क्या है
ये सवाल
क्या
है
तो अभी क्या बोल रही थी मैं बोल रही हूँ हाँ क्या भूल कर चाहिए आप आपने रख देते ना हाँ
पूछो क्या कहना चाहेंगे मैम
क्लाउड नाइन एक बहुत ही अच्छा हेल्थ केयर सर्विस हॉस्पिटल है वेयर इट्स लाइक अ वन स्टॉप शॉप फ्रॉम द टाइम द वुमन कंसीव्स टू द टाइम ऑफ डिलीवरी सारी चीज़ों का ख्याल रखते हुए और एडुकेशन भी देते हैं कि बच्चा ही नहीं बल्कि माँ भी इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट है और आई जस्ट थिंक दैट यू नो दिस इट्स सच अ ह्यूज डॉन्टिंग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वैन यू एक्चुअली हैव अ बेबी इन यू वैन यू मेकिंग अनदर ह्यूमन बींग कि हेल्थ केयर प्रोफेशनल का अच्छा होना बहुत ज़रूरी है और एंड सो इज़ द हॉस्पिटल तो क्लाउड नाइन एक बहुत ही अच्छा सेंटर है एंड आई फील वेरी हैप्पी टू बी इनॉग्रेटेड
दरवाजा नहीं।
अरे गिर जाएगा यार। पीछे देख।
अरे भाई तुझे पोर्ट्रेट खींचना है।